Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, we are going to look at Power BI inside of Microsoft Teams, how you can get the app installed by default and have it pinned. Let's do this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, Microsoft Teams and Power BI. I did a video not too long ago where I showed the new updates for Power BI, the new Power BI app inside of Microsoft Teams, what that can do for you. If you haven't watched that, go check it out. What I want to do is talk to the admins a little bit and let them know about a way that you can actually install the Power BI app by default, as well as have it pinned for everyone to make it more obvious that it's there. Now, if you're not an admin, still stick around. You should be aware of this, that it's available, so you can go talk to your organization and say, look, this is really cool to have for organization to make sure everyone can know that Power BI is there and they could take full advantage of it. Enough of all this talking. Let's head over to my machine and see how we can do this. As I mentioned, this is an admin thing, so only tenant admins and Teams admins can actually do this. I'm actually over on the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. You can get there by going to admin.microsoft.com, or if you go to the office portal, there's like a little admin icon. Once you're there, we're going to come down below to show all. We're going to go to Teams, and then with inside of the Teams Admin Center, you can go to the Teams apps area, and here there's a couple options. You can manage apps, there's permission policies, and then there's setup policies. We want to go to setup policies. There are two items that are there by default: first line worker and global org wide default. You can stick with those default policies, or you can add a custom policy as well for specific users. We'll come back to the custom policy item here in a second because there's something I think you need to know about that. But for now, let's stick with the global policy. So let's come into the global org-wide default. And here there's a couple things. First is the installed app, and then you have pinned apps. What's the difference? If we go and actually look at Teams, installed apps are going to show up in this ellipsis area. The pinned apps are going to show up on this bar. We actually want to do both because we want it installed and we want it pinned. So let's first add it as an installed app, do Power BI. You may notice two of these show up. We want the one with the new icon, which is this lower one. This was the old app before the update that happened a few weeks ago as of the recording of this video. I would imagine that this one may disappear at some point. I don't know. Let's just go with the new icon. We'll add that. It will show up here. Now we want to say, what are the pinned apps? So by default, these are the items that are pinned. We can say add app again, Power BI. We'll go ahead and add that. And now it will show up in the list. You can also change the order of these items if you want. I'm okay with it being down here as long as it's pinned. And then we're going to hit save. All right. So that's affected now in the global org-wide policy. One thing to be aware of is that once you've saved this item, the documentation says it could take a few hours for it to actually be present for users and actually see it show up. Once this is done and is propagated to everyone, what you're going to see when you go back over to Teams is you'll just see the Power BI app listed there and it will be pinned and you can just go ahead and use it. So this means that users, when they come into Teams, it'll just be there and they could take full advantage of Power BI. One thing to realize here too is that licensing still applies for Power BI. So if a user goes to this, they need to have the right licensing to work with Power BI inside of Teams. So this could be the pro license, it could be the upcoming premium per user license, or the content could be backed by premium itself. So those items are required to be able to use this inside of Teams. So I mentioned this custom policy thing, and like I said, you can add your own policy and you can add those items. You'll notice this is here, these installed apps are, it's just taking a copy of whatever the global policy is. Just gonna go ahead and add this real quick. We'll hit save. The thing that was a catch here is if I actually select my custom policy, you have to add users to this. It didn't look like you could actually add groups though. I know that we have like RLS specific security groups and they're not showing up. So you'd have to add individual users, which I don't know. I mean, if you're using these, great, you can add them to custom policies. Just to make it easier, I think you're going to want to do this on the global policy just for everyone. But if you do have a subset of users that you want this for, you can do that. All right, I want to hand this over to you. What do you think? Did you know that you could actually have the Power BI app in Teams by default? It's bananas. Let me know in the comments below what you think. I want to know. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.